Welcome back to Magic Tarot Cards. It's Jasmine. I have a 5-card spread here for you. This is for the zodiac sign of Scorpio. This is your December 2020 reading. Zodiac sign of Scorpio, December 2020. I'd like to say I appreciate with the cards. I have 5 cards here for you. Also, this video is not made for kids. If you're under the age of 18, please click off now. And this channel is my brand. Please do not try to copy it for any reason. Y'all, if this is general, if it doesn't resonate with you, please come back for another reading, or you can contact me in my email down below in the description box for a personal reading. All right. Let's get started with the reading. For the first card, we have the Three of Swords in the reverse. Okay, so when it's in the upright, we all know that that means heartbreak with a third party. So it looks like in the recent past, maybe during the Mercury retrograde we had in October, or recent or a little bit beyond that, you might have had a heartbreak or some type of disappointment. Yeah, I'm seeing a third party. Maybe if you're involved with the Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius, maybe they cheated, or a friend hurt you some kind of way, a family member, or just a third party. You see how the heart is pierced? The card, it looks like it's raining in the background. It's gray and gloomy. So that's the heartache and disappointment. Okay, but it's in the upright. So I'm seeing that maybe now you're getting over it. This is in the past. Sorry, I'll clean my cards as I go because they are. I've had them for a very long time. You're getting over this. It's coming to a pass. You might still feel disappointed and dissatisfied, but maybe it's not as intense. Your feelings aren't as intense as they were when it first happened. I am seeing an apology coming. If this was an ex that did you dirty, that cheated on you, there's an apology coming. Yeah, maybe this person wants to make peace, or if it's a friend, they're gonna call you back and say, "I'm sorry, for what happened. I didn't mean it." But this is not sincere. I don't feel like it's a sincere apology. I feel like they're just saying that to get back in your good graces, because something they want out of you. Maybe you were giving them money or buying them stuff. Yeah, I'm seeing all kinds of material stuff that you might have been doing for them, and now no one else is, so they're coming back for that. So an ex is coming back, and it could be an ex-friend, ex-lover, ex-family member, anything that's an ex. Maybe your job fired you and they're calling you back. All right, so the next one we have is the Fear card. Okay, so in the upright, again, this represents fear, fear, and more fear, fear and depression. The woman is blindfolded, man or woman, looks like a woman to me, blindfolded, and can't see what's behind her or in front of her, hands tied. So some of you might have felt this way when this heartbreak over here happened. You might feel like you were bound like this, bound from depression, bound from fear, or you might have created a self-imprisonment. A self-imprisonment in your mind where you just can't get out of those thoughts. I'm seeing that somebody actually went to prison or jail, or is about to go to jail, or coming out, because this card fell on the reverse for you. So what does it represent when it's in the verse? That literally represents that someone's getting out of jail. Someone's coming out of their mind about some kind of fear they had, or some kind of heartbreak. Yeah, some kind of heartbreak or some kind of restriction. Maybe you're restricted some kind of way by a friend, or maybe you were with a Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius that was very, very strict and restricting you, and now that they have gone away from you, you're not feeling those restrictions anymore. I'm seeing restrictions also for health. Some of you might have been in bad health and you were very restricted at what you eat, how you move about or places you go, stuff like that. But now that's passing. It's getting better. Okay, so I am seeing that. Yeah, I'm seeing your freedom almost being restored back to normal. Okay, now here's the thing. For the next card, we have the Two of Swords. So this represents a decision to make, kind of stuck in stagnation. So I am seeing some of you that might be stuck in stagnation after this X returns. You see, you got all swords here. You're in your mind a lot. Blue represents mind, deep thought. But you're at a crossroads because this person has their arms crossed, but they have their back to the water and they're blindfolded, meaning they don't know which direction to go. So I am seeing some of you that might feel this way. You might feel like confused because the ex is returning, or the ex-friend or whoever is returning, and you didn't think they were going to come back. So now you're a little bit confused. Should I take this path or that path? What should I do? So some of you are going to have a decision to make in the month of December, of not only with love relationships, but with friendships and work as well. Which job should I take? Which one would be better? Should I quit because they did me dirty? Or should I move on to something else? So I see a lot of you in your mind a lot about these type of decisions, whether it be boyfriend, girlfriend, friends, you know, family members or whatever. A lot of you are going to be in your minds about which direction to take, because the new year is coming. Okay, so once the new year comes, y'all want to be a whole different person. You want to shake the dust off your feet and just go and leave everything behind and start over in the new year. And a lot of us are going to be feeling that energy when January 1st comes. Now here we have the strength in the reverse. So in the other part, we all know it means strength. The lion represents life coming in, roaring in, you know, just rawr. And the maiden's trying to shut its mouth because, you know, we don't want life coming in that way. And then on top of her head is the infinity sign, which represents, you know, forever. So her thoughts are back here, way far away, because now the yellow is more dominant. But in the reverse, what does that happen? You got it in the reverse. It means that that's not happening. Some of you are clinging on to old worn out ideas or old worn out relationships or stuff that your ex used to say that he didn't honor, he didn't keep, but you still have to hold that in your head. You're like, oh, I remember when my ex used to do this and used to do that. Well, he probably never meant it because of y'all broke up because of a third party, right? So I am seeing this card here is literally reminding you that you need to gather your strength this month in December. And push forward, move forward. So you can flip this card back around. You want the infinity sign on top of your head, not underneath it like that. All right. So push forward, move forward, find your strength. You know, speak out if you have to. Speak about your feelings, your thoughts, your mind, or whatever it is that you got going on. Speak it out. All right. So for the last one, we have the Justice card. So this is a really good card. This means that justice is going to be balanced for everyone involved. I am seeing some of you might be going to court for something in December, maybe like a small claims court. This ain't a real big place. See, the judge is holding his power and he's holding the scales. The scales are balanced. So that means things are going to balance out for you in January and moving on forward, December and moving on forward. Okay. So I do see a court case coming, some of you, that, you know, you're going to get what you want. It's going to be balanced out for everybody. There might not be like no losers and everybody wins, that type of situation. The same with your jobs, boyfriends, girlfriends, whatever. I do see, I see the scales being balanced and things are going to work out for you. If you notice, the judge has got one little foot sticking out here. Okay, that always represents balance. When you see the feet, you know, two different ways, it represents balance. All right, and he's got his sword showing his power. That represents balance. And then the two scales are balanced out. All right, y'all. So it doesn't look like a bad month. I do be wary of the ex that's coming back because I feel like they only want to get what they can get out of you and not, you know, to be in a relationship. Now, they might be telling you, hey, I want to be in a relationship. Doesn't mean that they mean it. Okay, there's a lot of people that do that. A lot of people fake liking you just to see if they can get money or, you know, whatever it is you want to buy them or pay for them. So they'll fake liking you. Once they get tired of you, they leave. Okay. So just be careful with that. I am seeing, again, a prison. Someone might be getting out of prison and right in time for the holidays for some of you. And some of you might be going to jail. Yeah, you don't want to be one of those that goes to jail. All right. So, yeah, and then your big decision you're going to have to make here. So, this is your Scorpio reading for December 2020. Y'all, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. This is a general reading, doesn't resonate with everybody. But if you do want something to resonate more with you, book a time and date with me for a personal reading, and I'll get back at you. You can email me. All right, everything's going to be in the description box. Thanks for watching, y'all. Have a blessed day, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.